Thank you. And thank you. A very, very good evening to you. Welcome to the last of this series of the Late Late Breakfast Show. The producer said to me at the beginning of the series, if I managed to get through it in one piece, I'd be decorated. I didn't realise he was going to go quite this far. Actually, I think I'll get rid of that one. I don't think I require that. Got a marvellous programme lined up for you. In Stockholm, ABBA will be presenting two numbers, and I shall be having a chat with them. A chat with a difference, and I shall also be having a chat with a difference, and two numbers from Mr. Barry Manilow. He's live in LA, and that's coming in just a little while. Now, on last week's Whirly Wheel, our theme was car stunts. Unfortunately, my favourite one didn't actually come up, but there's always the next series. In fact, Robert Kennison got for himself the long jump. So, let's now have a word from Murray Walker.
Santa Pod is world famous for exciting motorsport. It's seen a lot of it over the years, but never anything as exciting as it's going to see here soon. Because very shortly, Robert Kennison, in an aged Hillman Hunter, is going to hit this ramp at over 70 miles an hour, nosedive into cars and come out of them safely.
And you can rest assured that if you don't stay tuned and you don't watch that, you're not going to kick yourself, because it's going to be a rather special incident. And that's no idle boast. Now, live to the west coast of America, he's picked up his pen, he's got his writing paper. Barry Manilow's going to write himself a letter.
I'm going to write them and write myself a letter and make believe it came from you. I'm going to write words oh so sweet that ought to knock me off my feet. The light of his head on the bottom. Yeah.
Thank you, Barry. And I shall be having a chat with him in just a little while, and we've got another number from him. Thank you for all the Christmas cards that you've been sending to the programme. Here's a Christmas card with a little bit of a difference. It comes from Japan, and if you open it up... Isn't that the height of bad taste? As you close it, it plays another one. It's playing my tune. Yes. I wasn't too sure about that either. Would you like to get one of those? Anyway, here's something that's going to give you the odd little giggle. Here we have the all-time top 10. At the end of the series, we present the very best of the People's Chart. At number 10, Mike Millman, BBC Plymouth's fishing correspondent, who stood out from all the rest for his brilliant in-depth interview technique. At number 9, that performance is narrowly outslipped by this one from reporter Jenny Murray in Wales.
The part that leads down a steep slope of an old coal tip, down to the river and the railway bridge, all irresistible. You see what I mean?
And of course, the final top 10 wouldn't be complete without Murray Walker, the chart's most regular guest and self-confessed master of missed timing.
Crafty design of big holes drilled in the windscreen. There it is, diagonally. And he has a theory which seems to be justified, that it helps visibility. What am I saying? What am I saying?
And at number 7, Newsnight's Peter Hobday returns for providing this year's most interesting background report.
Satisfy the problems that the British have on getting rid of this problem.
And one place up from Peter, two dastardly Russian spies. These days, a new spy seems to pop up every second week, but when it comes to subtlety of technique, it would be hard to outdo these two chaps.
Here are saying that Soviet troops have been put on the alert. Is that so?
I wouldn't put it as much as that. The impression I get is this, that at the moment, Moscow wants to exploit the whole situation to its advantage.
Of course, the People's Chart is not limited to people. At a number 5, we have 6 St. Bernard dogs, Ian Master's most outspoken guests.
Need to be watched.
No, the thing is, some St. Bernards get a canker in their ear because their ears fall over, so they've got to be prepared for vet bills as well. At the moment, all these lovely lads, lad and lasses here, are all in good health.
Hey, hey!
And at number 4, still with the animal world, our biggest talent discovery. Would you believe a sheep could fly? Well, that does deserve a bit of sheep cheering. And at number 3, Basil Fawlty and Manuel, who, since the demise of Fawlty Towers, have both been spotted moving on to new jobs. Manuel has moved from carrying plates to lifting weights, without losing any of his old style.
Lean the bar up onto the shoulders and the chest. Push himself forward.
He can't hold back.
He's coming off the stage, completely off the platform. He gets himself back on. So there's not much point going on, is there?
Meanwhile, Basil has been working as bodyguard to Prime Minister Begin. And onward now to newsreader Richard Whitmore, who's come out at number 2 overall for this superb moment of masterful timing.
In Liverpool, and his policies are directly leading to unemployment within that very large sector.
Excuse me, I've got a very lost my voice here. I'm sorry, I'm going to have to end this. I've completely lost it, unless you can understand me. Can you hear me all right?
And let's see that just one more time. And at number 1, we've been deeply honoured to welcome some distinguished guests into the chart over the weeks, but none perhaps more distinguished than His Holiness the Pope. Here he is now with his own special formula for the perfect Christmas pudding. That's 3 level teaspoons of caster sugar. 1 of cinnamon. And just a pinch of salt. Then the idea is one should really let the air get to it. Many thanks to all the BBC local stations who have helped us so much with the People's Charts, to the guys in BT, and thanks to Helen Fielding, who's worked very hard putting that together over the weeks. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I was chatting to Cliff, and I put to him the sort of questions that you might well get asked if a journalist from a teen magazine goes for you, that's if you're a big pop star. And I thought I'd try the same thing with Barry Manilow. I hope the delay on the satellite link won't cause any problems. Barry, can you hear me all right?
I can hear you fine.
Jolly good. Well, these are the sort of questions that I'm sure you've had put to you by all sorts of journalists. You have a limited amount of time to cover them, and your time starts now. What is your favourite animal?
Dogs.
The most boring film you've ever seen?
You know, if I tell you the most boring film I've ever seen, I'll probably get booed out of the country.
Go on.
Do you really want to know?
Yes, I do.
I can't tell you.
The most amusing person you've ever met?
Roberta Kent. Who else? I'm my friend, Roberta Kent.
The least favorite part of your body?
The least favorite part of my body? I don't know. I never thought about that.
All right, well, we'll move on. The least favorite garment that you've ever had?
Well, there was this jumpsuit that some costume designer put me in, and it was so tight. You know those high notes that you've heard me singing periodically? Because of that jumpsuit.
We'll move on. What is the wickedest thing that you admit to having done?
I've never done anything wicked. No.
What about your school report? What was the worst comment you've ever had?
Gee, I don't remember. I don't remember. Really.
Favorite relative?
Favorite relative?
Yeah.
I guess I'd have to say my mother.
All right. Well, that's a good one to stop on. Thank you very much indeed for doing those. I think I managed to flummox you with a couple, didn't I?
Yeah, how's things over there, Noel?
It's very good, thank you, Barry. Excellent at the moment. Nobody's hit me with anything on this week's show. You're going to do a number for us now, aren't you?
I am. Before I do, I want to wish everybody happy holidays over there, okay?
Thank you very much indeed, and have a very happy Christmas yourself. While you get yourself sorted out, he's going to present a number from Cats. It's an absolutely beautiful song called Memory. And at this very moment, a team of surgeons are removing his earpiece. 15 hairdressers are just smoothing the hair around his left ear. And I ought to get a thumbs up to say that Barry is ready to sing for us. Here he is. Barry Manilow, ladies and gentlemen.
I remember the time.
Thank you, Barry. And I shall be putting some of those questions to ABBA in just a little while. We'll see how they do. Now, we have a feature on this programme which has turned out to be very successful. We call it Next of Kin in the office because there's a very good chance that we're going to have a heck of an accident one day. Give It a Whirl has produced some amazing personalities, and I've invited all the contestants along for this last programme in the series. Ken started the whole thing off by wrestling with a crocodile. Bath time, I should think, is a little bit difficult for you now, Ken, isn't it?
Well, bath time and passing crocodile handbags. I feel like I want to get hold of them and wrestle them.
Frightened of crocodile handbags. Well, here we see the terrible beast. And for late comers, Ken is the one in the dark shorts. The thing was, his wife wished that it had been a real one. She got most upset about that. Have there been any more attempts on your life from the wife?
No, I haven't ended up with any stomach aches or anything like that.
Well, I wonder how much pain Brenda went through. We had you with the Hussani troupe, didn't we?
That's right.
Are you fitter now?
Oh, definitely.
You are?
Yes.
It's done you quite a bit of good.
Yes.
Well, here we can see you going through the routine. No, that wasn't Brenda. Stop. Here she comes. Great stuff. Now, this is the bit that really must have hurt. That must have been painful.
I think it hurt them more than it hurt me.
You've lost a stone since then, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
Well done.
Yes.
Good luck with the rest of the diet.
Thank you.
Then Paul, who was so clever, Clogs, that you made this look easy. You got the stock car racing at Bellevue, didn't you?
Down to sheer fright, really, I think.
But tell us about it, because you did make it look easy.
Well, I was getting so many sort of hits up the bat from Frankie that I thought, well, you know, if I don't get a move on, I should come out so damaged.
Well, hats off to you, because we were waiting for you to go on about the third lap, and all those guys were on to quite a bit of champagne if they had you off.
Yeah.
And you kept going. Well done, Paul. That was brilliant. And then we had Linda, And Linda came along with a very nice frock, didn't you? Very smart.
I did. It was nice at the time.
Yes. And we stood you against a board, and we threw knives at you.
Very nice of you.
What happened to the frock?
Well, it's in holes at home.
Is it?
Yes, but I'd like to have a go at knife throwing, Noel.
Oh,
I'd
fine.
Like
thank you very much.
I'd like to have a go at knife throwing at you.
Yes, I thought that was going to be the comment. Well, I see you're wearing the outfit which you got in return for the loss of the dress.
Yes.
So you're definitely into leather now, are you?
I am into leather, yes. It's safer.
Yeah. You're better upholstered than my car. Yeah. And then, of course, we've got the rollover lady, Pat.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
How's the driving been going since we featured you on the programme?
Oh, great. I passed another driving test.
You passed
last
the driving
week.
Test since then. Lovely. Well, this is what she did. She had to roll a motor car. And she did better than Dick Shepherd. She actually got it back onto the wheels. Brilliant, marvellous stuff. And then, of course, Sandra Crooks, our trapeze lady, whose boobies fell out on the television. Yeah. Can you believe, looking at that, can you really believe that that is you?
Well, when it falls out, yes.
No, I didn't
that
mean
is
that.
Definitely mine.
I didn't mean that. I meant that's pretty daredevil stuff.
Yeah, it does. It looks pretty. I don't believe that I did it. Oh, look. Oh, gosh.
Yes.
That's what my paper said. There's a headline on the front page today.
What does it say?
Flying striptease. Could have killed him.
Splendid. Well, you have my admiration, all of you. We'll meet some more of the Whirly Wheelers in just a little while. But now to this week's stunt, and it really is quite an amazing one. It features Mr. Dick Shepherd again. Let's go back to Santa Pod.
Robert, you're an adventurous chap, I know, but how does the thought of the daunting thing you're about to do grab you?
Slightly frightening, but I'm looking forward to it.
And you've had no practice, of course?
None, just a lot of advice and sort of verbal tuition.
Well, up there is Dick Shepherd, and Dick Shepherd is going to give us a demonstration of how to do it. So, let's get him on his way. Dick, let's go.
Yellow flag yet, so I wonder if he's going to be able to find the ramp. If you hear a stifled scream at this point, it's because the producer, Michael Hurl, has just realised that's his car we're using. Now, here he comes.
And I think second gear.
Murray
he's
can
coming
see him
down.
Now
he's lining up for the ramp. Let's see if he's going to take another gear. He's got his hazard lights flashing, I see. He's lined up beautifully for the ramp, and he hits it square on. Dick Shepherd seems to be perfectly okay. Let's see if he's out of the car. Yes, he is. He's okay.
Amazing. I don't know about you, but that actually made me feel quite ill. Anyway, Robert Kennison, you see why we call it next to kin now. Robert Kennison, our amateur, will be doing it in just a little while. Stay tuned for that. But now, ABBA. And from Stockholm, I Had a Dream.
Dream. my destination makes it worth the while. Pushing through the darkness, still another mile. I believe in angels, something good.
I can tell you the pictures are courtesy of Swedish TV. I can't tell you the name of the choir, but I shall find out in a moment. I shall ask them when I chat to them in just a little bit. And we've got another song coming from them. But I've also got some more whirly-wheelers here, plus that Dame Edna nutter at the far end. Chris, hello.
Hi there.
You got the rough and tumble with the acrobatic troupe, and your little boy, Thomas, he seemed very amused to see that you were dressed up as a woman.
Yes, he's taking after me now. He walks around the house all the time, in fact, with a wig and a dress on. Great fun.
Must be very confusing in your household. And then there's Robert, and you got the bed of nails. Now, I have a feeling that this looks a lot easier than it turned out to be.
It was, yeah.
Painful?
Very.
Very painful. And reaction from friends after you did this?
They insist I didn't say a lot. There were three no's and not much.
Yes, you didn't say very much at all, did you?
No.
Why was that?
You didn't ask me.
Oh, didn't I? Sorry about that. Well done, Robert. I think that required a lot of guts, and we nearly saw them. And then there was Pam. And Pam, I shall never forget your Whirly Wheel challenge, because that was the day of the 100 weight of mashed potato. This is probably your finest hour, this bit with the chandelier. What's it like beating up men?
Oh, quite nice.
It's good fun.
Yes.
Are you inclined to do any more of it?
No, I don't think so.
Here's the great moment. Look at this. Oh! All 6'6" of him out of the window. Thank you for that, Pam. And Mukesh, hello. Yeah. I'm really pleased to see you again. You gave me a terrible time. A real heart attack. You got escapology. What kept you so long?
Oh, I thought I'd keep you waiting.
You thought a bit of showbiz?
Really?
Yeah. Thank you very much, Mukesh. I really appreciate that. We thought you weren't coming out. And that one also was a lot more difficult than it looked. As for this one, hello, Helen. We met last week, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
You're the abseiling fiend. Have you had a quiet week since then?
No. Had a cold and I've got some bruises.
Had a cold and you've got some bruises. Yes. This is marvellous. When you ran down the front of that building...
That was painful.
Was it?
Yeah.
Tell me something. Where are the bruises?
I'm not showing or showing.
I think we can guess. And so far, the biggest nut that's come up on the wheel. Undoubtedly. Steve, you got the wall of death.
Yep.
Did you honestly believe that you could do it?
No way. Those lads got me up there and... On the Monday, I could have been sick over that wall.
You really could. Well, I really have to say, quite seriously, you got all our admiration for that one, because we wouldn't have minded if you bottled out there. We could have always shown one of the professionals doing it, but you did it so well. And then your wife went round, Denise went round the handbars.
Amazing,
she?
Yeah.
Yeah. Like to do it again?
Love to. Yeah.
Well, just outside in the car park, we've got...
Around the BBC.
Marvellous stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, can we have a round of applause for all our worthy winners? If you would like to take part on the Whirly Wheel in the next series, we'll be back in the autumn, we want to hear from you. Also, if you've got a subject for a Hit Squad hit, we would like to know what you'd like us to do, because the squad will be working all through the spring and next summer. And for both suggestions, would you please write to this address? It's the Late Late Breakfast Show. Here's the address. Go on. Think of a hit. I'd love to hear from you. Over in Stockholm, the four people I had the pleasure of meeting just a few weeks ago. Hello to you all.
Hello. Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well indeed. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Fine.
And you getting all your Christmas plans sorted out? Been doing any shopping?
Not yet. I'm afraid I should have, but I haven't.
Yes, you should.
You're always very late, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Well, just a few moments ago, I put a list of questions to Barry Manilow, the sort of questions that I'm sure you've been asked by many... sort of pop magazine journalists.
Yes, you're right.
And I wonder how quickly we could get down the line here. It's one question at a time, one for each of you. Let's start off with you, Bjorn, if I may.
Yeah.
Your favourite animal?
My favourite animal is a moose.
Why? Why the moose?
I think it's a lot like me. It's big, tall, very handsome.
I've heard they smell a bit. Anyway.
They do.
Frida, the most boring film.
The most boring thing?
Film.
Film. Oh.
The one you were in.
Yes.
Yes.
That's true.
Agneta, the most amusing person you've met?
Person?
Yes.
Henry Fonda.
Oh.
Oh, I thought Noel.
Very
also,
good. You've got a rotten one here, Benny. What is the least favourite part of your body?
Well, I'd say all of it.
Back to the other end. And could you please tell me, what is your least favourite garment, Bjorn?
My least favourite garment is probably the one I had on when we won the Eurovision Song Contest.
The one you have now.
Because, you see, it was so tight, I could actually not sit down in it. It was terrible.
You were thick.
Oh, I was very fat at that. Yeah, that's
a good bit of aggravation going on here. Frida, what is the most annoying mannerism that you've ever seen in somebody?
Mannerism?
Well, you have to explain mannerism.
Mannerism, no, I understand that. I think it's jealousy.
Yeah.
Would that be the right answer?
Yes, the worst feature, certainly.
What's it?
Agneta, what is the worst holiday you've had?
The worst?
Worst holiday.
I only had good holidays.
Oh, lucky you. What about the best Christmas, Benny?
Well, they're all the same, aren't they? Nobody ever gives me any presents, you know.
Oh. You're going to get a lot this year.
Thank you, Bjorn.
Bjorn, what is your favourite relative?
My favourite relative is my good old rich uncle in Wisconsin.
Frida, I'll give you another terrible one. What is the worst thing that you ever had on your school report?
Nothing, I think. I was very good in school.
Let's keep that one also for Agneta. Did you ever have a nasty comment on a school report?
I think the same goes for me.
Did she ever go to school?
I was very talented.
You have a marvellous life, don't you? Great holidays and nothing rotten happened to you at school. All right, well, let's wrap this up. Benny, I think this is the most awkward one for you, and I want total honesty now. The one question you'd never answer.
Is there any?
What is the one question you would never, ever answer?
Well, I can't come to think of one, actually. Try one.
Well, that's a shame, because that's what I was going to do the moment you told me. Okay.
Shoot.
Well, obviously, everybody over here wishes the four of you a very happy Christmas indeed.
Same to you.
Same to you.
And many congratulations. You have an enormous hit on your hands with your LP. Number two in the UK charts at the moment. Did you know that?
Oh, I thought it was number one.
Well, you can't have everything.
Oh, would yes, you can.
Well, it's not a bad philosophy. You've now got to get yourselves wired up. Would you like to get ready, please, for the next number?
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay. Once again, the experts move forward to rip out the earpieces and get them sorted out. That LP, that amazing album, which I suppose will make quite a good Christmas gift, because I wouldn't mind having one, that's the number two in the charts. This one is a new entry into the charts. It's just hovering outside, so I wonder whether it'll make it into, say, the 20 or the 10 this week. It is, of course, called Under Attack, and here we have, ladies and gentlemen, ABBA.